Hello everyone, welcome back to Me School for Ninjas. I'm John, here playing Rimworld. In the last episode, when I left off, we were preparing for a raid of tribespeople, and here they are. There's actually quite a few of them, which could be a problem for me, because my defenses, as you know, are not terribly prepared for this kind of thing. But hopefully, with strapping Macey and Jari all working overdrive, and actually Jari, buddy, I'm gonna need you to focus on the constructing, please. And also, let's get Omega in on this, and let's get me on it. In fact, everybody build right now. Everyone's building. So, sorry if you're sleepy, but everyone builds right now. No one gets to rest. Oh. Apparently there's still lamps that need to go in. That's not really a priority, Jari. You've got your priorities all wrong, but it's okay. It's not your fault, dude. At least everybody else is hard at work building these up quickly, please, because they're right here. Oh my god, let's take a look at these bad boys. We've got Olga. He's a male archer. Oh my god. He's quite good at melee. But he is carrying a bow, thankfully. We've got Senra, who is carrying a handful of stones. Oh wow, he's quite good, actually. Tona? Another archer with a pila. This time, though, so she's actually got a throwing spear. Redfields, this guy, oh my god, this guy's nasty. He's got great shooting, but glad he's carrying a club. He's also quite a good melee, though, so this could be bad. We got a Bruno, who is great at shooting and is carrying a bow. He's going to be deadly. And a great meleeer with a club. Excellent. Well, oh, it's Bacchus. Fucking hell. Okay. Well, these guys are bad news, for sure. I'm not sure if I'm terribly ready for this, actually. Ooh, boy. It's okay. These turrets will go in. Hopefully. Soon. Oh my god. This is actually taking quite a while. Despite everything. But, all the metal's in here, guys. Come on, hurry up. Please hurry. For the good of the fucking colony here, hurry. Would you? I don't know how long I have. I probably don't have much longer before these guys are coming at me already. And the turrets are not even... one turret is in. Two turrets now. And this one has already lost power because the rain is blocking power to the fucking solar generators. This is bad. This is a very bad situation. This rain needs to stop. Oh my god. Who has guns? I think I only have 3 guns in the entire colony, too, is part of the problem. Oh, I'm panicking a little, guys, actually. I'm panicking. I think this might be the biggest threat Me School for Ninjas has faced yet, and it is not prepared, and my guns are going in and out. Oh my god, this is awful. Oh no. Why did that just become a roof region? That is not a roof region. Please. I'm glad I noticed that. If I hadn't been looking at that moment. No roof region. Right here, guys. This is no roof zone. Please. There we go. Oh my god. That would have been even uglier if I lost my fucking... one of my generators. One of the only ones I have. Ah, jeez. Okay, well, fuck that generator. Let's just go for the one. And hope... oh, what's this? At least I have all these visitors, because that means, with all these visitors, I like to call these guys cannon fodder during a raid, because I'm just going to let them stand outside and take all the hits when the tribespeople first come in, while I hide behind my walls and don't invite them inside, like, you know, Strappy's going to go out there, because, you know, he's, as the designated asshole, the groupie, go out and be like, hey guys, how you doing? Just wait outside, we'll be right with you with some refreshments. You know, we got, like, treats and drinks and stuff here in the school. Jari's gonna whip up a great feast, but you just wait out here for 2 seconds. Definitely no tribespeople attacking right now. Oh my god. Right now? Really? Okay. Can I? Oh, hurry up. Hurry up. Here they come. They are coming, guys. The music has gotten kind of intense, too. Ah, jeez. How many of these turrets can I get in? Strapping, are you working on a turret? No. You should be, but I can't make you. I have 2 turrets in already, so that's good. Jesus. Here they come. Macey? Are you almost done? No, not really. Oh my god, not even close. Ah, well, there's no more time. Macey, get in. Everyone, drafted, except for Strapping, who's gonna finish the wall. And let's set up our defense. Can you finish this turret, actually, Strapping? No, there's no time. Get inside, buddy. Alright, everyone inside. Get out of the rain. Get away from these crazy tribes people. Okay, just wait out here, guys. We'll be right back with the feast. Definitely no crazy tribes people here. Oh god, here they come. Run, Macey! Run, Strapping! Frankie! Get your friends out of here, Frankie! This is gonna be a fucking bloodbath! Jesus! Ah, they're already going for the turrets. Oh, jeez. Oh, that's gonna explode on them, though. That's gonna be kinda hilarious. Oh, one guy's down. Oh, look, they're hitting their friend. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, Bacchus is down. Okay. Who's got guns? We've got Jari, me, and Dunsmore with guns? All of you. Okay, me actually take the top station. And you guys, I hope you're ready for this. Alright, begin the assault. Go, 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 everyone. Go, go, go. Me, take position up by this bed. Oh no. I don't want you accidentally hitting those guys, actually. Get back inside. You two in here. You right there. We're gonna wait for them to destroy my turret, I guess. There's nothing else I can do, unfortunately. It looks like this... It's okay, though, because I'll rebuild it. It'll destroy this wall. This wall turned out to be a very good idea for the explosion from the turrets, anyway. I've never done this before, but I'm gonna do this from now on, for sure. Okay, the turret's about to go down. Because I don't want them to accidentally shoot the guests and have the guests turn on me. Dunsmore and Jari are having a chat there. It looks like the tribespeople are discussing their options. They're like, do we storm the place? What should we do at this point? They're going to storm the place. Well, I've got a surprise for them. Dunsmore, Jari, me, to your stations. And fire at will. Go, go, go! Oh my god. Oh no. Jesus, he's a tough bastard. Okay. Jari and Dunsmore, retreat. Me, retreat. Oh my god, get inside. No, don't get shot, Dunsmore. Get in. Oh, jeez, they're going to break in. Me, can you pop out for a shot? No, 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 no. Get in, get in. Oh my god. Okay, wait right here. And as soon as they pop in, me's going to take a shot. Meanwhile, where are the other tribes people? What are they doing? Okay, Jari, get up here. And you get up here, Dunsmore. See if you can take... Oh, no, don't shoot at Jari, dude. Yeah, see if you can take this guy down. Because he's a dick. Aw, Dunsmore. You guys are terrible shots, aren't you? You guys are really bad at this. He is right fucking there. Come on, you can't hit this guy. Oh yeah, they're fleeing. They're done for. Oh. I was so worried too. Omega. What? When? What? The fuck? How did I not notice this? No, Omega! How the hell? Who killed Omega? How did I miss this? Oh. This fucking door. Tona apparently snuck in through the bottom goddamn entrance, killed Omega, and ran for it. Ugh, poor Omega. Wow, in one goddamn hit. Well, the good news here for everybody, especially for Macey, is we can strip Omega and take her clothes. Yay! Macey has clothes. Although, we could have taken it from any of the colonists, actually. Well, what a sad, sad day. Okay, we need to build a grave for poor Omega. Our first casualty. Oh, rest in peace, Omega. I barely knew you. Though I barely knew you, you were very briefly a friend. And you shall be the first grave. Oh, that's a terrible way to do graves. No. Where can I actually line them up? I want to line them up here. Yeah, here we go. Let's get a line of graves here. Let's bury all these fucking tribespeople, I guess. Although I'd rather you didn't bury the tribespeople because, you know, there's better uses for their bodies. I mean, because that's a waste of space. Eventually I'll have an incinerator and I can just toss their bodies in a furnace and not have to worry about them. However, no, not Macey. Oh, who just had to stand there and watch it happen, apparently, because I'm an idiot. Oh, I feel so bad about this now. I can't believe that I didn't see this happen. Okay, well, me is going to personally bury Omega because she feels bad. She never got to know Omega, unfortunately. And it was the first student that she's lost, so this was especially hard for her. And let's leave those forbidden for now. And you guys just stood by and let it happen. How terrible of you. But let's allow these weapons, because I think I'm going to make use of these bows, for sure. Actually. Wasn't there a dead guy over here? I thought there was a dead guy over there. Maybe they got him and picked him up and took him away or something? Fucking, you're an asshole, Tona. What are your thoughts? You're just panicking. Well, you're an asshole, Tona. Oh no, how is everyone feeling about this witness and ally's death? Yeah, they're not very happy. Witness a stranger's death. Jari apparently did not feel as strongly. Oh well, that's because he didn't watch it happen. Wow. Even Strapping was a little shaken up by that. That's saying something. Strapping's usually pretty unflappable, but standing there and watching, you know, that guy burst in and they didn't know what to do, and they just watched as poor Omega's throat was cut in front of them, and then the guy just turned and ran right out the door, and he got away clean. Unfortunately, the murderer runs free, but not for long, I think. Let's unforbid these so they can get rid of them, and me, actually, let's strip all these bodies so that we can make use of these in case any naked drifters come to us in the future. We can make use of those guys now. These clothes, I mean. And poor Omega's knife. Oh my god. You know what? What have you got, Macey? You've just got a knife too? Well, you're gonna take Omega's knife, Macey. Macey gets up in the middle of the night and she goes out back into the hallway. And she's going to stand here for a minute. She sees me, and me doesn't say anything to her. She just keeps walking, because she knows. She knows why she's here. Macey stands here for a minute. Then she picks up the knife and looks at it. And it's now her knife. And just to spite the people that killed her new friend, right in front of her eyes, you know, like not the exact people, but the tribe, Macey's gonna go over here and grab one of these meals and just eat it on the ground, apparently? Why are you eating on the ground, Macey? I guess she wants to eat it next to them, just so their corpses are aware. Look at me. I am out for vengeance. I am eating your food. I'm gonna find your friend that killed Omega, and I'm gonna kill him. Wow, Macey has turned very vengeful now. She, unfortunately, has seen way too much in her time already. And look, she's already hard at work now. She's up and she's like, no, I'm not going back to bed. And actually, that reminds me, I should really take everyone off of all of construction mode again. Because that was really an emergency situation. So we're back to normal pattern now. Yep, okay. And let's set this mining back up here. Man, it's tough out here in the rim, but this is what you have to do. You have to just move on. And why did you not bury her? Okay. Finish this grave, please, Macey. And... What? It requires resources. Build this grave, Macey. Would you? Kindly? And then, if you would, once that is done... Come on. Okay. Please bury Omega. Macey comes out here, she personally digs the grave, and she buries Omega. Of course. But there's no time to mourn anymore. She goes back to work now, with new purpose. Oh god, why is this guy just laying in the middle of my fucking stockpile? Well, we're not going to worry about that right now, I guess. Doesn't look like anyone is really too concerned about it, actually. Me. I need you on hauling, I think. Do I? Wow, Dunsmore. I don't know why Cleety was number one there. I didn't mean that. Okay. Well, actually, let's see here. Who... Macey hauls sometimes, but not lately. She won't be hauling much. Oh, that's right. Omega was my backup hauler. Well, she isn't around anymore, guys. So, me. I know you'd like to research, but there's some hauling to be done before these corpses start to turn. And the smell starts bothering everybody. You gotta take them in. Get them out of sight. I know it's tough. But the colony does move on. Ah, look, these visitors are finally leaving. Bunch of fucking assholes. That just sat here in the middle of the battlefield, like, eating fucking popcorn. You know, watching things go down, like, yeah, we could help, but it's more fun this way to them, I think. You know? I think they heard that the tribespeople were on their way, and they were like, oh, well, this should be good. And they came to watch, like the sick bastards they are. Well, I guess if that's the kind of people they want to be, I can't stop them from being that those people. Okay, well, this door down here probably has to go. So, I'm going to do this. And you guys focus on that after a bit of this dugout. And... I'm going to set up that food storage, because I'm just going to go ahead and close this wall now. Jari's going to be really angry for a couple of days, but then he'll see them come in here and start mining out, and he'll be like, oh, I see, okay. He'll understand, I think. Oh, wow. That's right. All of these bedrooms also need to have their walls laid back in, because I just tore everything up in my fit of trying to get this base ready for the pending invasion, which it turned out we were actually pretty ready, and had I been paying more attention, we shouldn't have lost anybody, but because I was so focused on what was going on, you know, on one side, I let them get me with the flanking maneuver on the door that I forgot that I had, you know, the fucking Achilles heel of the fortress, Jari's cooking door. But that's why it's going away. No more. No more will bandits sneak in through the back entrance and stab my innocent, terrible at fighting crew members to death while my other drafted crew members stand there and watch in mute appeal for me to just order them to attack, but I don't, and they can't move because they're drafted. Well, I guess on that note, this actually seems like a good place to end the episode. There we go. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. I'm sorry, I'm a little down. It was a tragic day at Me School for Ninjas. We lost not a dear friend, but a new friend. Someone who had a lot of potential to grow and become a great student here in this school for ninjas, but unfortunately never got to realize that potential because she got stabbed to death by a tribesperson in the hallway right here, and her shit is still everywhere. But on the bright side, we are a little bit richer now because apparently Omega had a bunch of silver on her. But as I was saying, thanks for watching. This has been John and Me School for Ninjas. And I'll see you guys next time.